God bless you, pal. That was a lovely prayer. But how many of you listened to the beautiful words of the song that was sung, that God can widen the river and he can move mountains? And that is very true. Because you see, if you have faith in God, faith in spirit, you'd be surprised what can be done for you. Because you see, God works in mysterious ways. His wonders he does perform. God and spirit work for us day by day. We don't always see what they do for us, but we do feel the benefits. We reap the rewards that they bring towards us. Know this, Spirit Divine does attend all prayers, and they do attend because they hear you calling through your heart, asking for the help, asking for guidance, asking for that of healing. Know this, my friends, spirit will never fail man, but man will fail spirit. It is a true fact that through life we have seen so much that has happened. We have seen so much that has taken place within the universe of the earth and with man upon it. We see they do not look for the truth. They do not seek for the knowledge. They do not reach out their hands. They do not share their love that's within their heart. We see many that close their souls down to what should be, not to what they feel. Know this, my friends. Spirit can work with man in many ways. Many of you come into this group. Many of you are searching for knowledge. But many of you just want to understand that when the physical body is no more of this earth, that you go forward into the realms of spirit. And you want to know that you are going to be greeted with your loved ones and friends that have come before you. This will happen. This you can be assured of. We use this vessel to bring words towards you, to give you guidance, to bring upliftment, but most of all, to bring truth to you all. Because you see, man does seek for knowledge, but they see what they want to see, hear what they want to hear, and discard everything else, which is very important, as it should all combine together to bring true knowledge. Open your eyes so you may see the glimpses of truth that spirit can show towards you. Open your mind, your third eye, which you can hear, see, and feel that of spirit that draw close to you. But open your heart to man, open your heart to spirit. Show that of love, show that of compassion, show that of truth of the being within you. Know this, we in spirit, we do not come looking for that of the glory, for in spirit there is no glory. We come to share, to help, to give guidance, so that each and every one of you will open your eyes to see truth. You must question, you must doubt, you must seek, And when you see, you will see all that will be placed before you. Know the words that have been spoken, are spoken for you, so that you now can call upon the spirits with your questions, so that you will find the answers that you are seeking. So I shall step aside, and as I step aside, I will allow our sister to come forward towards you.
Hello, my friends. I hope today each and every one of you have come with the energies and that of the energies of love, and you have come with words that you wish to speak so that you can have the answers from the spirit realm directly to you. We know that sometimes you find it difficult in bringing your tongue to move, to give to that of the questions, because you feel foolish. Never feel foolish when it comes to questioning of spirit. What might sound silly to others is important to you. And you must realize that if it's important to you, you must always search for that of the answer of truth that we in spirit must give towards you. Do not think, however, that we in spirit, we are an encyclopedia. We have only the knowledge that we have gained within the realms of spirit. And we learn so much here, but we do not come to speak to you to say what your future will be, what your fortune will be. We are not here to bring those words to you. We only come to share knowledge. So my friends, I am waiting for your questions, and I will speak only of truth towards you. God bless you, my friends.
God bless. May I ask of your permission to allow others to ask their questions, sister?
Oh, yes, my brother. That would be very nice for you to do so.
Thank you. God bless you. The first person is Linda today. I'm just unmuting you, Linda, to ask your questions to our sister.
Good evening, sister.
Thank you for allowing questions.
My question is about our spirit guides. I have been working with spirit for a while, a few years now. And it seems to me sometimes it is the same energy, but in a different guise, as it were, that steps forward depending on what work I am doing. Could that be that I may not have as many guides as I think, because it may be the same energy, that same spirit, that comes in the appropriate form?
Let me explain to you, my dear. It is very important to know this. You as a medium, a mediator between the two worlds, you know that you have one and only one guide, but you have many helpers that will come in and out, bringing different energies towards you. Sometimes they will bring that of strong energies. Sometimes the lower energies, depending on your physical body at that moment of time. Because you see, my dear, when the body is low, the energies cannot come as strong to you as they normally do. Do not feel that spirit of those of your helpers are becoming less. They are not. What you must understand is this. We in the realms of spirit that are your helpers, when we have to come to you, we have to learn first of all to understand you yourself, how you will work, and we have to get to know you inside out. And that is why you will find that many of your helpers will leave you for a short time. They go to the school of learning. They gain greater knowledge. Then they come back into you. They come toward you with greater words of wisdom. So, my dear, do not feel that the energies that you are feeling is saying to you that your helpers, your guides are changing. They are not. They will always stay close to you. You understand?
Yes, thank you.
Bless you, my dear.
And also, a question about my own path. I'm sitting to develop and become more in the trance state, working in the trance state. There's so many different theories on how we should sit and in what sort of lights and putting protection up. Is there any advice you could give me, please?
My dear, I could give you lots of advice, but I will tell you this, that it is important for you to know. We see so much where light is concerned, and of those who say that we will teach you to become in trance. Let me explain to you, save your time. You are a vessel that knows how to go deep into your meditation.
Yes.
When you go deep into your meditation, this is when we have spirit. We will come to you. We will come. We will place the energies within you. We will place the energies around you. And when you start to speak, we will watch first of all how the tone of your voice comes. We then work upon the vibrations of the tones of your voice. We then place words within you yourself. You may find that the vibrations of your voice is no longer sounding as you normally do. This is because we in spirit, we take control. We watch men within life who say, we can teach. They can only explain to you how to go into your deepness. Mm-hmm. But they cannot teach you how to be controlled by the spirit that will use your voice. As you can see with the vessel, the vessel, he did not sit within any teaching group. We worked upon him naturally. And you can do the same. Because when we see a worthy vessel that is worthy to use, we use them and we come strong. So, my dear, I will only say to you this. Trust your helpers, trust your guides. They will not fail you. They will always come stronger to you. When you call upon them, ask them to take you deeper, to take control. you will see this come about, and others will hear the words that you speak, and they will feel the energies that will come from you, because it's true from spirit, you understand.
Yes, thank you.
God bless you, my dear.
Bless you.
Bless you. So the next person on the list is lovely Kate. So Kate, if you would like to ask your questions to Mrs. Doubtfire.
Come on, you are getting yourself into trouble.
Good evening, Sister Safina.
Hello, my dear. It is lovely to see you and hear you once again.
It's wonderful to be here amongst all these lovely people and to be able to ask questions.
God bless you.
A few nights ago, I haven't been so well and I haven't been meditating or doing anything spiritual. I've just been trying to concentrate on getting my energy back and getting well. And I was sat quietly on my bed, just thinking about nothing in particular, when I suddenly felt something very, very close to me in front of me. And I felt a breath on my face as if someone was breathing on me. And I was quite alarmed at first because it was half light and half dark. And I thought I was just disorientated. But this continued until it came into a very, very soothing and very reassuring and loving feeling. Now, my question is it possible for spirit to breathe onto you, to put motion onto you? Or is this just a figment of my imagination?
My dear, you have that of a hymn which you sing many times. Breathe on me, breath of God.
Yes.
Yes, spirit can breathe upon you. My dear, I will explain very, very carefully to you. We have been watching you. We are aware of conditions of your health. We are aware that you have been calling to spirit. My dear, never be afraid to say you have fear within yourself when it comes to the physical body. Every living being has that come at one point or another. But for you to experience that of the breathing placed upon you, that came from the partner, the loved one in spirit, that would have suffered with the breathing conditions before his transition.
Right.
He came close to you and he was giving you love. He was reassuring you that all is going to be well. You must stop worrying. It is very easy to say, but let me tell you, my dear, we in spirit, we know all, we see all, we feel all, and you can be reassured that the physical body is being taken care of, not only from man of the earth, but of that of the healing angels in the realms of spirit. You must wipe your tears and be strong, have faith, and look forward, because your life is ahead of you. You understand?
I do now.
God bless you, my dear.
Thank you very much. I don't have another question at this moment, but thank you.
Well, I hope you do, my dear, because it is always a pleasure to hear your voice and to hear the vibrations of the love that comes from you. God bless you, my dear.
God bless, Safina. God bless.
Right. The next person on the list is lovely Gillian. I'm just going to unmute you, Gillian, to ask your question to Sister Safena.
Can't hear him.
You can.
Yeah.
Question.
Hello?
We can hear you.
Hi. Are spirits genuine?
Oh, my dear, how beautiful. That is the question I have not heard for a long, long time. Of course, spirit is genuine. If spirit was not genuine, how can you live? Because you are a living spirit within yourself. And it is when you take up the transition, the spirit that is within you that gives you life, takes that of its energies and goes forward into the realms of spirit. And there is greeted with loved ones and friends who have come before, but they soon learn that they are having the best of both worlds because they are with their loved ones in spirit and are able to see their loved ones that are left behind. So do not doubt of spirit, my dear, because you are a spirit. And if you doubt of spirit, this means you are doubting of yourself. You understand?
Yeah.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Do you have any more questions, Gillian?
Yes. Why do they? I keep getting white feathers?
My dear, you know, we in spirit, we always send a sign to man of the earth. And many times, the white feathers are the easiest sign to show to man that we are around them, that we are close to them. We walk at their side. Many times you will hear men say, a white feather is brought to you from the angels in the realms of spirit. They are the healing angels. They are the ones that come towards you. When you are at your lowest, that is when they pick you up and move you forward out of the darkness into the light. So we always like to show to you a sign. And the simplest way is that of the white feather that floats from the sky, from that of your healing angels and guides, to say to you, I am here. You understand?
Yeah.
God bless you, my dear.
Thank you.
Right, thank you. God bless. Right, the next person is Jesse. I'm just going to check. Are you able to speak, Jesse? Just going to mute you.
Yeah, I'm fine.
That's okay. You may ask questions to Sister Svetlana.
Hi, Sister.
Hello, my dear. It is a long time since I have heard your voice.
Yeah. May I ask a question, please?
Of course you can, my dear.
My first question is for spirit guidance, please.
My dear, spiritual guidance is a very simple thing to give to you.
Yeah.
Follow your heart. Listen to your instincts. Listen to your gut feelings. You are asking many questions at the moment of time of your material life. You are doubting yourself. You are doubting your capability. You feel as though when life is concerned, no one is helping or supporting you. And you ask the question many times within yourself, what can I do? Well, I will tell you very, very simply. Listen to your inner voice. We have spirits speak to you daily, but you do not always hear. We speak through your instincts. And when we speak through your instincts, you must follow them. And it will show you the way forward. because all shall and will be well for you, my dear. But you know life is like climbing a mountain. It's easy when you first start, but when you get to the middle, it becomes harder and harder. And that is the time when you need support from spirit and support from men, you understand.
I do, yeah, thank you.
God bless you, my dear.
And you too.
Bless you. Thank you. Right, the next person on the list is lovely Carol. I was going to mute you, Carol, because you've been waiting a few weeks.
Good evening, sister.
Hello, my dear.
May I ask a question, please?
You may ask many questions, my dear.
What happens when you become the channel as a healer?
When you become a channel of the healer, first of all, my dear, you have to remember this, and it is very important. One that is chosen by spirit to do the healing, they have to allow spirit to draw close to them. It is not always easy when this is placed in front of them because they do not know what they should be doing, how it should be done. If you call upon your helper, your guide, which is your powerhouse, who brings the healing, they will take control of you and they will come strong and stronger to you, so that then you will be in control of yourself and of your energies that spirit has placed for you to share with man of the earth, you understand?
I do, thank you.
God bless you, my dear.
May I ask another question, please?
As you can, my dear.
How long does it take before spirit comes back to this world after death takes place?
My dear, you should know this question yourself. There is no time in spirit. And because there is no time in spirit, no man can say when a spirit will return into that of the body of the earth. To you, it may take a century. To the spirit, maybe a week. You see, having no time, you have to understand that once the spirit is in the realms of spirit, there is so much for them to do, so much for them to learn, so much for them to have to see before they are allowed to ask them the question of the elders, may I return? So to that question you have asked, my dear, there is no time at all. You understand?
I do, thank you.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Right, the next person after Carol is Sherry Ann. I'm just going to mute you, Sherry Ann, to ask your questions to Sister Savannah.
Thank you. Thank you, Sister Savannah. May I ask a question, please?
You may, my dear.
I'm very interested in vibration. And what vibration that us on Earth, on this Earth, vibrate at, and how does spirit, how much energy must spirit make to meet us on this Earth plane?
My dear, you say you work upon vibration. It is not vibration you work upon. It is on the sensing of the energies you work upon. Yeah. Vibrations are that of the ripples, of that of sounds, the beating. But when you work with that of the energies that are placed around you, you sense them. You sense those energies. And when you sense them, that is when you start to look and ask of spirit, which way am I to go? How can I work with the energies I sense? How can I deliver them to where they are to go? You do not realize, my dear, when we have the spirit come to man of the earth, there is so much that we have to first of all do. Many in life think that you can call upon your loved ones and they just open a door, come back to the earth, and they can speak freely to you. It does not work that way. First and foremost, we in spirit, we have to ask for permission to come to the loved ones of the earth and those that we wish to use. We then go before the elders who see what is taking place and knows why the spirit must come to the earth. So then they start to tell them how to work upon the energies. For they have to use energies, first of all, to bring the silhouette, that for man to see. And then they have to use the energies to share to man, so that they can speak and their words can be heard. Then they use the energies to place the conditions upon the living being. Then they have to use the energies to make man aware who it is that is with them. There is so much, my dear, that you must learn. We do not work with a vibration. We work on the energies. And the stronger the energies, the stronger we become. The stronger we become, the closer we can become to you. Has that answered your question, my dear?
Yes, thank you. May I ask a second question?
Of course you can, my dear.
So how can I raise my energies to meet those from the world of light?
You do not. You cannot. You have that of your powerhouse. You ask of them to raise the vibrations of the energies. That is part of their duties, to help you. And you will know when they are doing their work, because you will feel the warmth, the heat, that will flow right through you. You sit at this moment and you can feel those energies coming at this moment of time, because you have become very warm within your physical body. You understand?
I do, sister. Thank you.
And that is how it must be, my dear. You make that of your powerhouse work for you. Do not allow others within life to say to you, we can teach you how to do that. They cannot. They cannot. Because you see the energies. How can you draw them towards you? How can you raise them? No man can do this. Only your powerhouse. You understand me, my dear?
I do understand, sister. Bless you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bless you. Right. The next person on the list is Lexi. Are you free to ask your questions, Lexi?
Yeah, okay. If that's okay. Good evening, sister.
Hello, my dear.
I hope you're well. I have to ask if you'll forgive me. I didn't really know what to ask. So I've just sat in admiration listening. I guess I'd love to know, there's one question that I've always wanted answering, if that's all right to ask.
Well, you can, my dear.
Thank you. So I've always thought that my children were bought from my grandfather in heaven who passed away. I've always felt that he brought me all of my children. Am I right in thinking this? Is this something that you would be able to answer for me?
It is very simple, my dear. Let me explain something to you. Where your grandfather is concerned, the bond of love is very strong within you and also in the realms of spirit. You say that your grandfather brought that of your children towards you. He did not. He did not. But what he did do, my dear, within you, he placed the seed of the generation, you understand. And because of this, remember your grandfather, your mother, your father was part of him, and you are part of your mother, your father, and your children are part of you, you understand?
Yeah.
So it is the seed that is being placed through the generations, what you call the genes, you understand?
Yeah.
That bond will never break, my dear. That bond will never break. The one thing grandfather would do, because he loved children within life, he will look after them, he will protect them, and he will give them guidance. So do not think for one moment that grandfather sent the children. Them children are part of your grandfather through that of the seed of the generation.
Thank you.
God bless you, my dear.
God bless you.
You have another question, Lexi?
I'm okay. I'd love to just listen to somebody else. Thank you. Thanks.
Right, the next person on the list is Sue. I'm just going to unmute you, Sue. There you go.
Good evening, sister.
Hello, my dear.
Can I just ask that after our open circles on when we do them at church, and I've given out our messages and we closed down our circle. Because Spirit put on me their conditions on their put on me, or I have to try and work out whether it's male or female for the weight and everything. Sometimes I find it a little difficult to bring myself back up after I close back down.
My dear.
Is there a reason for this?
Yes, my dear. One, first of all, when you open up your channels to allow the spirits to come to you, you do not ask them to place the conditions on you. You ask of them to make you aware of the conditions, whether it is of man, whether it is of woman, and whatever conditions they took the transition with. All you want is to be aware of, not to have it placed upon you. Because once it is upon you, it takes time for that to be taken from you. And if you are not strong enough to remove it, this can stay with you for some time and affect your physical body. So please, my dear, when serving of God and serving of spirit, do not allow them or anyone to place the conditions upon you and your physical body. Ask them to make you aware. There is a big difference, you understand?
I do, yeah.
My dear, please, may I say something to you?
Yes.
We know that you are a worthy vessel and have been for some time. But your physical body is not strong enough to be taking conditions upon it that are from spirit. That is why I am saying to you now, my dear, I will speak to your guide, your helpers, and ask them just to make you aware, not to place it upon you. We want you to be strong in body and in mind. You understand?
I do, yes.
God bless you, my dear.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, God bless. Do you have another question, Sue?
Not just now, Kyle. Thank you.
Okay. Right, the next person on the list now is lovely Jan Boat. Just unmuting you, Jan.
Good evening, Sister Safira.
Hello, my dear. Lovely to hear your voice.
Thank you. I haven't spoken to you for a while.
I know, my dear. But it is always a pleasure to hear the beautiful vibration.
Thank you. Can I ask you a question?
You may, my dear.
Right. Do you think I'm going in the right direction to sit in circle?
My dear, why do you need to sit in circles? If you are a leader of a circle, I would say completely yes, because the knowledge you have within you, you can help others to progress and grow within that of knowledge of spirit. If you want to sit within a home circle, then that is a completely different thing, because there you will be sitting with others of like mind and of understanding that you can share with each other to help you to even grow more. But if you was to say, I want to go and sit in a circle, why? Why would you want to, when spirit are already working with you, helping you, guiding you, giving you strength, giving you healing? No one else can give that to you within a circle. So, my dear, the choice is yours. You understand?
Yes, I understand.
God bless you, my dear.
Thank you.
Next person's Mark on the list as well, anyway.
Hello, sister.
Hello, brother.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you, brother. And I know that you are, because it is a time for you to ask questions, because you seek up knowledge of truth. You understand?
Yes. Okay. I'm just wondering, it's a bit of a personal question, this, and I hope you won't get offended, since you, a lady, has passed into the world of spirit. But I was just wondering, how long, what was your age when you passed into the world of spirit, and how long have you been in the world of spirit? Would you know?
Oh, my brother, let me explain something to you. First of all, you know it's bad manners to ask a lady of her age, but because I have been into the realms of spirit since that of the 13th century, and because I have been here for so many years, I do not worry of age, but I was 36 of the years within the life, you understand?
I understand.
So
yeah.
Therefore, brother, do not look at the time of whom and when. Look at what has been given. So much knowledge, so much strength, so much healing, and you are starting to grow with it. You must find your helper. You must find your mainstay. Once you find them, then you must ask questions of them so that your mind can be open to what and how and where they came from. You understand?
Yes, I understand, yes.
So you are not being personal, brother. I liked the question.
Good.
Because now I will tell you what you will do. You will start to search, and you will start to look back and try to find what you are seeking. You understand?
Yes.
There you are, my brother. You see, we are in spirit, we know a lot, and we want you to continue to do so.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome, brother.
Okay, thank you very much.
I just cheated and Googled when the Aztecs were around.
Well, brother, you are a naughty boy. Because you see, you can look up on your computer, but they cannot tell you what you do not know. Because you see, we only allow that of man to know so much knowledge of what is. You have your scientists who say that they can take you back to this, that, and the other. But many of the scientists, they do not work in the way that they are meant to be. I will tell you, we do not trust them in the realms of spirit, because you see, those that scientists, they exaggerate. They are the ones that place things that are not there and say things that are not true. So you see, my brother, you have been naughty because you have only looked upon the computer to see what man has put man within life. You understand?
Yes, absolutely. But I just need to say, I'm the next on the question, but anyone else who has more questions, please write into the chat. And if you've already asked questions, you can ask again. Or raise your hand if I see it. Carol Rains will hopefully let me know if she gets back. But sister, may I be able to ask two questions, please?
Oh, you can, my brother. We'd love it when you speak to us.
Yeah. So mine was already along this line, but in a weird way. When spirit choose an astral body where they come close to the earth in the use of that energy, I know that spirit takes on the individuality of that astral form, such as its emotions and stuff. Now, I know that this energy was on the earth in the sense of when they were living, but when spirit's using this astral body, can it develop through them emotions where it didn't develop through life when new spirits start to use this form?
Oh, my brother, everything starts afresh. Everything starts afresh. What vibrations and conditions that was on the spirit that was taken into the realms? Remember what is. A spirit is a living energy, a living thought. Those living thoughts go into one direction. And your living spirit, the energy of the soul, goes into another. So when the time comes to return within the physical body, remember they are cleansed of all. So they have to learn how to use new emotions, to learn how to use new feelings, There is so much you must learn, brother, about that of spirit and of that of the physical body. You understand?
Yes, absolutely. That makes perfect sense. Yeah. Thank you. God bless you, sister. May I ask another question?
You may.
I've not asked for spiritual guidance in a while, so I feel now's the appropriate time to ask for spiritual guidance.
This is the time I have been waiting for. Brother, I will speak to you through the vessel as I have wanted to say for some time. You are asking for spiritual guidance. We have been close to you, closer than you will ever know. You have questioned yourself. You have doubted yourself. You have doubted that of the capabilities of spirit. Yet we will not fail you. Your guidance, I will say to you, is this. Stay strong to your faith. Stay strong to yourself. You do not understand, brother. You are a gift. You are a gift from God. You have been sent in the form of that of a physical body. You was given a condition that you call an ailment that affects you, that places that of the doubt within you. Yet if you look and you listen carefully to what I say, your disability is a gift that God gave to you because you have a brain that stores so much knowledge more than other men. Your brain is one that reacts quickly. You doubt of yourself and you say, why am I being given this disability? Let me tell you, do not look at a disability, look at the gift. The gift that is given to you. Look at the positives, not the negatives. Because when you are positive, look at you, my brother. Look at how we come strong towards you. You are one that is wise. You are wiser than you think. Others look up to you. Yes. We know you are fiery, but you know that is also part of your gift because no one can walk over you within life. Go forward, serve your God, serve your spirit, but most of all, serve yourself. Your future will be brighter than you think. We have lots in store for you. You will have your eyes open very soon to what is about to be. And that is to show to you the truth. The truth that spirit will hear your prayers and will work accordingly on all aspects within your life. So, brother, I am grateful for the opportunity to speak as I am towards you. You do not realize we in spirit, we are so proud of you. We love you. You are one that we cherish. And that is because God gave you a gift. Remember, It is a gift, not a burden. Now I must leave you with those words, my brother, and hope that you understand what words have been given to you.
I do. Thank you, sister. God bless you very much.
God bless you, brother.
Right. Shalima is the next person on the list. I'm just going to unmute you, Shalima, to ask your questions to Sister Safena.
Thank you. Hello, thank you for taking my question. It's kind of a personal one. My oldest son, I feel, has been going through something the last 2 weeks. His behavior is just erratic and just so angry. And I just don't know if there's something that, if it's something he's going through with energy going around or something that I can do to help. I mean, I don't know if I'm asking the question properly, but I'm just worried.
My dear, you are a mother. A mother that is worrying about their children. Yet your son, he is one that is finding himself. And because he is finding himself, he is finding it frustrating. He is finding it hard. He is finding it so that he does not know who to turn to. You see, he is trying to become the man. And trying to become the man means that he must stand alone. And when he tries to stand alone, he becomes agitated. He becomes angry at everyone and everything around him. This young man will prove his worth where life is concerned. All you have to do, be that mother that will be there when he calls towards you. When he turns towards you, hug him. Hug him and tell him you love him, because that love is what will keep him strong. That will help him to grow where he's going through the conditions of confusion of growth. You understand?
Yes, thank you.
God bless you, my dear.
You too.
Right, next question is Linda again. Just going to mute you, Linda.
Thank you. My question is about animals, mainly our pets. But I seem to feel that I have cats, but I do know people that have dogs, but they seem much more naturally aware of spirit energy around. But when our pets pass to spirit, do they come back in the same way? I have been aware of my living cat seems to be following another little creature around at times in my flat. Could you sort of just enlighten a bit on how it works with the animals?
My dear, you have just answered your own question, because you see, animals, they are living spirit, whether they are of a cat or of a dog, that of a rat, that of an animal of any kind. They are living spirits. But I must tell you, a cat is more susceptible to the energies of spirit than man itself or even dog itself, because they are aware of the senses. Their eyes see what man cannot see. And when they do go into the realms of spirit, they do not change their form. They are a cat in the realms of spirit, in the sense of the spiritual energy, but not of the body that once was. Mm. And yes, they come. They come back into life, because where the love they receive, they know it will not go, and they love to be around it. And that are left within the animal kingdom of cats, they will follow, they will see, they will sense. So, my dear, always remember, that of the cat is most susceptible, but all creatures born to that of the earth are a living spirit. You understand?
Yes, thank you. That's God bless you, Nadia. Thank you. God bless you.
God bless. Right. That was no one who wants to be on the list again, so I'm just going to say, oh, Sherry-Ann, lovely. I'm just going to unmute you, Sherry-Ann.
Thank you, Kyle. Sister, may I ask this question, please? And I expect it's been asked a million times before. When a person here on earth, they pass away and their spirit leaves the body and returns to what I would call the world of light and love. When we sit in circle and we get the vision and we connect with the spirit, how difficult is that spirit in whose past come back into an earthly body so that we can recognize them? I don't know whether I'm sorry, I haven't framed my question properly, but
we understand what you are saying, my dear.
Thank you. But
let me explain to you. When that of a spirit leaves of the physical body and goes into the realms of spirit, which you call the light of love, when they are in the realms of spirit, remember, it is a living thought, and that living thought will continue to live within every thought and every energy that is there. When it returns to the earth, it does not return as it once was. It is cleansed of everything. So when the spirit is returned within man, you should not be aware of anything from the past life at all. You must not feel anything, nor see anything, be aware of anything, because that spirit has been cleansed, you understand?
Yes, I think I do, sister. Thank you.
You see, the only time, my dear, that man of the earth will ever feel and understand these words I give to you. When one is chosen to serve our Father God, and is a channel to work with spirit, they will then come close. They will come close to that being, that living soul, so that the conditions can be placed upon them so they are aware of whom and what and why. You understand?
I do, sister. Thank you.
God bless you, my dear.
Bless you, sister. Thank you.
Bless. Right. Does anyone else have any questions? Just raise your hand. Nope. You can. Yep.
Not to take everybody's time. A question, please, again, sister. When we... you spoke earlier in answer to another question about when we are ready, when we want to come back to the earth, we would speak to the elders and get their guidance. Now, we often hear about that we sort of have a contract to what we come to achieve, to experience. How is that decided what we should do?
My dear, I have to laugh at what you have just spoken. How can there be a contract? Because we in spirit, we do not have a pen to sign. We do not have paper that has the printing upon. When you leave of the physical body and you are taken into the realms of spirit, it will take much time for you to learn lessons. And when we say lessons, experiences, you have to go through many experiences in the realms of spirit. And when you have gained great knowledge, you then put in to that of the helpers that are with you to ask that of the elders of spirit to allow you to return up the earth to share that knowledge with man within. There is no contract. When one is chosen to be born upon the earth and the spirit is to enter into a body, they are shown their path of life, and they accept whether they want to take that journey or not, because we in spirit, we have free will, and it is up to us whether we choose to take that journey. No contracts, no paper, no pen. You understand?
I do, sister, and thank you. That helps me a lot. Thank you.
Bless you.
Bless you. Right. If I may ask a question, then two more after me, sister. And we can call back the vessel.
God bless you, brother.
Bless you. So my question is one what's quite been on my mind as well. Will I ever be able to achieve a strong connection to spirit without the reliance on things like music and other things to allow those effects to come stronger?
My brother, we love you. We love you. Let me explain to you. You are yourself. You are unique. You are special to us in spirit. What you use within life is of your own choosing. We will use you, the vessel, to do our bidding one way or another. You see, let me explain to you. I will not open to the group to hear, but you will understand the words that will be given to you. You speak to the vessel, and you speak in privacy, and you speak of what is with you and what is happening to you. This is how we connect with you through him, because we hear your words. We feel your pain. We see your tears. We know your doubts. We know your questioning. So, brother, listen to me and listen carefully. We in spirit, we do not just choose anyone. We choose the best. And you will be the best, but you must do what you must do. You must do what you feel is right within you. Do not allow others to question you. Do not allow others to say to you, this is right, this is wrong. Remember, this is your journey. You understand?
Yes, sister. God bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you. Okay, so Jesse, you're the next person to ask a question, so I'm just going to unmute you.
Hi again, sister.
Hello, my dear.
I want to ask a question, Riley.
You may, my dear.
I just wanted to see how my loved ones and spirits are doing.
My dear, let me explain to you. Those words are very beautiful because you are asking, how is my loved ones in spirit doing? They are doing very well. They are happy in the realms of spirit. The ailments that once was on the body are no longer with you. They are able to watch over you. They are able to come close to you. They are happy. But in the realms of spirit, there are very far, there are far that are very close towards you. And the far that is the closest will never ever be far from you. They will always be there. You must learn within yourself to sense their vibrations and to sense their love that they bring towards you. You understand?
I think, sister, she's had technology difficulties, so I will send her the video with the answer on it, because she says she cannot hear, and I think the internet's taken her away from the group.
My brother, I am so sorry to hear that. You see, it is very important for the young lady to have heard the words that spirit spoke to her. If you can, I don't know how, relate the words to her to hear, we in spirit would be very grateful.
It'll be done tonight, sister.
God bless you.
God bless you. So now the next person to ask a question is Jan Bolt. I'm just going to mute you, Jan Bolt.
Yeah.
There you go.
Hi, sister, again. Can I ask you another question?
Oh, yes, my dear.
Right. Can you just tell me how many times I've returned to spirit and how many times I've returned back to earth?
Well, I'll tell you for a start-up, my dear. You have not yet returned to spirit because you see a body only lives once within life. Your spirit within, first and foremost, when it leaves of your physical body, remember the words that have been spoken many times. The living thought goes one direction. The spirit within goes in another. And the spirit within that has learned great knowledge with living in the physical body, that knowledge is cleansed from the spirit. It has then had time to progress in the realms of spirit. And it is up to the elders whether it should return within any physical body of the earth. So when you say, how many times have I returned? You haven't, because you have not left the body. So you cannot return to what is still within. You understand?
Yes, sister.
It is only Kandam Bankiawa Yushola Maya Siawaya. My dear, I will interpret the words that have just been spoken in my tongue. You ask that question because others within life have told you that you have been here before. that you will come into the body several times. You have just been given the true answer. Do not listen to the foolish tongues of men. Because you know this, my dear, your body is but one, just one shell, not many. You understand this, my dear?
Yes.
So therefore, you go forward. You gain knowledge from that of spirit, not of man. Not of man. So I say God bless you, my dear.
Thank you, sister.
God bless. Thank you for the healing tonight, sister, as well. It's very calming. You may return the vessel, and also, if you wish to speak philosophy, you may do so.
God bless you, my brother. My friends, every time that we use the vessel, it is always an honor. It is always a privilege. And he is willing to let us use him at all times. What you do not see, what you do not hear, is the vessel himself, is the body within. It is not as strong as it should be. He has gone through many ailments and pains and suffering. Yet he allows us to use up his body, to use up his tongue, to come to help you that are seeking the knowledge of truth. This is what we call a worthy vessel, one that puts spirit first and themselves last. Everyone who wishes to progress into that of the understandings of the workings of vessels by spirit must always know this. They should be sincere. They should be dedicated. They must be honest. They must be humble and willing to serve at all times. This is why this vessel is very special. So you see, my friends, you should be grateful for what you have received from us in the realms of spirit, but mainly from the vessel that has allowed us to come within. God bless you all. Remember this, my friends. Call to God. Call to spirit. We are waiting to serve you, to help you, to guide you, to make you aware that all is meant to be is that of the truth within. So you can work forward within your life with that of the great knowledge that spirit is always around you. I say God bless you and thank you.